This is my friend Wilma. She's been grounded from playing Fortnite for a whole week. But if you hit the like button in the next 5 seconds, she'll be ungrounded. We give 3 subscribers every single day here on the channel, so if you want a chance at receiving a gift, be sure you hit that subscribe button and let us know your epic ID down below in the comments. Welcome back, everybody, to Home of Games. We are quickly approaching 2.5 million subscribers. It's absolutely mind-blowing to think about, and I have something huge planned for when we do hit 2.5 million. So if you're new around here, be sure you hit that subscribe button. And I also want to say a special thank you to everyone who uses code Home of Games in the Fortnite item shop. It directly supports the channel, and the money we make from that, it funds all the giveaways we're able to do. So the more of you that use the code, the more gifts and V-Bucks we'll be able to give away. So seriously, a super huge thank you to all of you who are using code Home of Games in the item shop. I appreciate it a lot, and I know the Home of Games community appreciates it a ton as well. And if you want to make sure you never ever miss a giveaway that we're doing on Home of Games, make sure you go follow my Twitter at Home of Games YT. I tweet out every time we're doing a giveaway, whether it's on Twitter or in a live stream over on Caffeine. It's the best way to stay up to date with the giveaways and Fortnite news, so make sure you go follow us, link in the description. But a few days ago here on the channel, I posted a video discussing a brand new glitch that Epic Games accidentally added in the new update 11.20 just last week. This video went over a glitch that was displaying a weird amount of refund tokens available to players. Up until this point in Fortnite, we have only been able to get 3 refunds in the entire lifetime of our Fortnite account. In case you're unfamiliar with the refund system, which is totally understandable because it's pretty hidden inside of the Fortnite game, you have to go into the settings, scroll all the way to the right, the furthest right tab, and that is where you will find the option to refund an item. The refund system will allow you to return any item to the item shop and get your V-Bucks back that you used to purchase the item that has been purchased within the last month. So any item that you bought from the item shop in the last 30 days, if you still have your refund tokens, you are able to go refund it and get your V-Bucks back. Now, like I said, each player is only allowed 3 refunds in the entire lifetime in their account. And I don't know about you guys, but as soon as the refund feature got added to the game about a year ago, I burned through those refund tokens. I did not use them sparingly whatsoever. Literally, oh, we got 3 refunds, and I instantly used all 3 of them, and honestly, I'm kind of regretting it. But then if we fast forward about 6 months from the original release of the refund system, a lot of the Fortnite community was asking Epic Games for more refund tokens, not because they just want to get more V-Bucks on their account and exchange a skin that they may not use as much anymore, but because a lot of players, and I know I've done this at least a few times myself, were accidentally purchasing things from the item shop that they didn't actually intend to purchase. Since inside of the item shop, all you have to do is click purchase item, there's no confirmation screen that pops up asking you, are you sure you want to purchase it or anything like that. So it is very, very easy to accidentally hit one button on your controller and all of a sudden, boom, you purchased a $20 skin that you never meant to buy. Obviously, the community was not happy with this because who wants to waste one of their 3 lifetime refund tokens on an accident? Like, the thing that the refund tokens are supposed to be used for is getting your money back and trading the skin in, and you got to use this skin for a little bit, but you still get your refund. It was a great way to test out a new item or test out a new reactive back bling or anything like that and actually see it in game without actually having to buy it. Since so many players were accidentally purchasing items, Epic Games started to get a lot of demands for more refund tokens inside of the game. However, Epic Games decided not to do this and actually implement a feature that allows you to refund any item as soon as you buy it from the item shop as long as you haven't exited the item shop screen. So let's say you're looking at today's item shop, you're looking at the new skin, and all of a sudden you accidentally click the purchase button on your controller. If you did decide that it was an accident, or you just changed your mind right after you purchase it that you no longer want the item, there's a little button at the bottom of the screen that allows you to instantly cancel the purchase that doesn't use any of your refund tokens. This was Epic's answer to people accidentally purchasing items, and instead of giving people more refund tokens, they just implemented this little thing, and so it would be pretty easy now to refund an item that you accidentally purchased. So we've already received two new additions to the game of ways to refund items, but fast forward to current day in the last few months, Epic Games has been getting a very, very high demand for another way to actually earn those refund tokens, not the ones that you accidentally purchase some from the item shop and you just refund it, but the actual ones that will give you V-Bucks on your account as long as the item was purchased in the last 30 days. When the update 11.20 came out last week, almost every single player was seeing an amount of refund tokens on their account that didn't make any sense. Up to this point, you were only allowed 3 lifetime refund tokens in your entire lifetime, and that's not very many at all. But with the release of the new update, if you go and look at your refund tokens, you may see any number appear. I've seen as low as 3 refund tokens and as high as 14 refund tokens available. Unfortunately, you weren't able to use any of these refund tokens, and it was only a visible glitch. However, Epic Games did come out publicly and make a statement explaining the glitch and clarifying exactly what was happening, hinting at something major coming to the refund system very, very soon. Now, we discussed this glitch in the refund token video we posted a few days ago, but we can notice that there is some correlation between how long you've had your Fortnite account and how many refund tokens were being displayed. People who had had their Fortnite accounts for a long time, like since season 1, they would see a higher number of refund tokens displayed in their settings than someone who had created their account more recently, like in season 8 or season 9. The community absolutely loved this idea, and it makes a lot of sense that they would implement a system like this. After all, if they were to implement something where every season you would get one extra refund token, or something along that lines, Epic Games wouldn't actually be losing out on any money at all. This would essentially act as a trading system. So if there was a skin that you bought a month ago for 1200 V-Bucks and a new 1200 V-Bucks skin was just released, it would allow you to trade your 1200 V-Bucks skin for another 1200 V-Bucks skin once every single season. This would also help the community and the player base stay way more active. If players are able to look forward to refunding a skin and getting a new skin once every single season, it's something exciting to look forward to, and it's definitely going to incentivize people to log on and play more Fortnite, which is ultimately great for Epic Games and the Fortnite business plan. I can't imagine they are opposed to the idea of growing their game or keeping the players online at all. But as I said, Epic Games did come out and make a public comment on this glitch, showing us a little bit of insight into what is actually happening, why these refund tokens are displaying, and what it means for the future of not only the refund system, but Fortnite as a whole. But Fortnite owns multiple Twitter accounts, not just the Fortnite Twitter account, but also a few other ones, one for the creative side of Fortnite, one for the Save the World side of Fortnite, and another one for the status of Fortnite. If there's any glitches or bugs or the servers are down or something like that, this is the Twitter account that will let you know what's going on and will also let you know whenever the issue is resolved. But what's the best part about this tweet I'm about to show you is that they don't ever at any point say that they aren't planning something, and they actually vaguely hint at it. A tweet from @FortniteStatus reads, "We're investigating an issue with refund tokens displaying incorrectly." I believe Epic Games made this purposely short and vague for a very, very good reason. Now, them saying that the refund tokens are displaying incorrectly isn't explaining the number that it says we have totally available. For example, mine says I have 8 refund tokens available, but if I only use 3, that means I should have 5 refund tokens available, right? Right, that math checks out. 8 minus 3 is 5, so I should still have 5 refund tokens available. And if we refer back to the tweet that they made, it says that the refund tokens are displaying incorrectly. They didn't specifically say that the second, or like the total number of refund tokens is displaying incorrectly. They just said the amount of refund tokens in general is displayed incorrectly. So does that mean that the amount of refunds we have currently available is displayed incorrectly? Meaning that instead of saying 0 refund tokens are available, it should actually say 5. And that is exactly what they said in this tweet, that the refund tokens are indeed displaying incorrectly. With the holiday season approaching and people guaranteed gonna spend more money on video games and presents and whatnot than any other time of the year, it would be the perfect time for Epic Games to add a system like this. They would benefit immensely from it, and overall it would help the health of their game a lot. While only time will tell, and we'll see what this week's 11.30 update holds within it, I can only imagine that if this was a total visual glitch, that Epic Games, seeing all the hype around refund tokens coming back to the game, that it's gonna be in their minds now. And I expect that we could see something like this come to the game very soon. Promise to keep you guys up to date with any of the latest developments inside of the story as soon as they break. So if you're new around here, be sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of it. I appreciate you guys watching this far into the video. You truly are the best. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to come tune into the live stream we do 3 times a week, go download Caffeine. It's a free live streaming website. Make an account totally free and follow the Home of Games stream. We give away a ton of V-Buck cards every stream. Send 3 gifts every single stream, so you don't want to miss out on that. But thank you guys again so much for watching, and I hope you all have a great day. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.